Hello, I'm Nergis Canefe, and I'm a professor of politics, public policy and law at York University, Toronto, Canada. Welcome to a five-part podcast series on phenomenology of violence and its contemporary applications. This series has been supported by York University, their project funding, and it is organized in tandem with the Institute for Human Sciences in Vienna, Austria. Throughout these five episodes, we'll be exploring some of the major themes and thinkers whose work is recognized in this field. We will also be discussing my theory on societal wrongdoing and collective accountability in the context of mass crimes. This is particularly relevant to the current events related to the ongoing Russian war against Ukraine and European and global responses to that war. In the first podcast, I invite you to join me to explore some of the main questions that ignited the discussion on the contemporary relevance of phenomenology of violence. The second, third, and fourth podcasts will be on individual thinkers, namely Jan Patocka, Hannah Arendt, and Edmund Husserl. The fifth and last podcast will be a discussion on contemporary applications of phenomenology of violence. Land acknowledgement for York University recognizes that many indigenous nations have long-standing relationships with the territories upon which York University campuses are located that precede the establishment of York University. York University thus acknowledges its presence on the traditional territory of many indigenous nations. The area known as Tekaronto has been caretaken by the Anishinaabeg Nation, the Haudenosaunee Confederacy, and the Huron-Wendat. It is now home to many First Nation, Inuit, and Métis communities. We acknowledge the current treaty holders, the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation. This territory is subject of the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, an agreement to peaceably share and care for the Great Lakes region. Let's begin with the first podcast. Revisiting Histories of Violence, a Phenomenological Inquiry. Politics left to itself bears tyranny within itself. Immanuel Levinas. The impulse of research must proceed not from philosophies but from things and from the problems. Edmund Husserl. Traumatic injuries in societies remain a direct source of moral urgency for revisiting theories of mass violence. This is despite interpretative difficulties posed by historical records pertaining to such destruction, or lack of them thereof. Indeed, narratives of political violence occupy a notable space in the humanist tradition. Starting with the Florentine humanists of the 15th century, the discussion of the relationship between authority and politics allowed for thinking mass violence through interpretative and methodological interventions. Contemporary political philosophical thought, in particular phenomenology of violence, invites us to reinvestigate the humanistic elements in the study of recorded as well as unacknowledged forms of violence. This brief podcast explores the ways in which select continental phenomenological traditions challenge the entrapments of debates on mass violence. As these debates conceptualize violence as a modality, practice, and part of a larger critique, violence is redefined as a historically situated phenomenon in constant need of social, political, and cultural authorization and reinvention. The palpable workings of violence and its institutionalization are often seen as foreclosing alternative spaces of survival, agency, resistance, and above all, understanding. And yet, mass violence is not simply about the exercise of domination, oppression, and suppression, nor is it mainly about annihilation. Phenomenological studies of violence constitute a field of critical thinking which, in their rejection of formalizing or essentializing violence, force us to re-examine the concrete historical realities to which they refer as their subject matter. These studies present us a relational study of violence and its constitutive role in our political presence, cultural embodiment, intercorporality, and sociality. In order to achieve an integrative understanding of both physical and symbolic constituents of violence, as well as its direct, indirect, and hidden effects manifesting themselves through the institutional structures of society, phenomenological analysis readily comes to our aid. Simply put, it strives to capture the transformative aspects of human domination and suffering. In particular, explication of the Husserlian phenomenological tradition allows for the falsification of the argument that phenomenology cannot account for others' experiences. Contrary to the presumption that phenomenology accounts for others' experiences only by interpreting them as the same as one's own, the Husserlian employment of temporality and reflexivity and its ethical engagement with others renders the development of a shared understanding of violence possible. While much of this podcast is dedicated to the historicity of violence and the conditions of its representability and narration, it is part of a larger endeavor to continue a conversation about the violence of our contemporaneity with philosophical reflections on the limits of understanding the violence and suffering that happens to others. How to understand war, violence, and their excesses relationship with history in terms of human capacity to create and to destruct, to give life and to annihilate, often seemingly for the very same reasons. Ultimately, a relational phenomenology of violence, exploring the constitution of actualization, embodiment, and intercorporality of human existence, as well as examining constituents of violence and not just the end product itself, is paramount in pursuing this inquiry through a relational reading of Jan Patocka's edifice of the solidarity of the shaken. Ultimately, a relational phenomenology of violence, exploring the constitution of actualization, embodiment, and intercorporality of human existence, as well as examining constituents of violence and not just the end product itself, is paramount in pursuing this inquiry through a relational reading of Jan Patocka's edifice, The Solidarity of the Shaken. Eastern Europe is often associated with violence in the European historical, political, and social imagination. At the same time, forms of non-violent practices, resilience, survival, and rebirth are significantly underrepresented in theoretical and historical discussions on the region, despite the fact that these are integral to the region's social and historical experiences. In order to deconstruct the pervasive, almost ritualistic association of Eastern European societies with forms of everyday as well as mass and extreme violence, in this series of podcasts, we will invite a phenomenology of violence that facilitates its negation through a shared and intentional understanding of histories of violence as exemplified by Edmund Husserl's notion of noema. These past few decades have presented us with multiple new challenges, from the Syrian exodus to a global pandemic, to the abyss in Afghanistan, followed by the invasion of Ukraine, and many more, which have led many of us to question the role and value of law and legality and the kind of accountability that emanates from the address of mass violence via the use of such tools for solving contemporary crises. This is a brief study of phenomenology of violence inspired by the work of Jan Patocka, while reading him in tandem with Hannah Arendt's work on judgment and reading Husserl's work in that context as well, in an effort to restore faith in the human capacity to understand the hell we create on Earth. As a series of podcasts examine the role of judgment and philosophical engagement in the determination of the scope of the involvement of law and legality and accountability in such crises, it revisits Patocka's interpretation of the First World War in the sixth of his heretical essays. As Patocka declared, the excessive character of the 20th century was best exemplified in the dangerously romantic conception of force. The series thus invites the audience to commit themselves to a deeper reading of Patocka's seminal essay, Wars of the 20th Century and the 20th Century as War, as well as his heretical essays. Regarding the issues of war, excess and responsibility, violence confronts us everywhere, but its distribution is uneven. Furthermore, its ubiquity begs the question of how to mark its place in the construction of meaning and trajectories of human action. Violence happens as loss of meaning. Its most fundamental characteristic is its foundational prowess to annihilate, as articulated by Patocka's reference to polemos. And as Arendt's voice rings so clearly over the many acts of organized violence, the most violent human activities are not conducted by essentially violent subjects. Violence is an integral part of the registers of modernity and not external to it. Phenomenology of violence does not begin with the assumption that violence represents the breakdown of meaning, nor is it necessarily irrational in terms of commission of harm. Although the traditional idea of violence indicates it to be an abnormal state of affairs and envisages responses to it primarily through its suppression, the problem that marred both Patocka and Arendt was precisely about mass violence being considered ennobling, redeeming, and necessary to the continuance of life itself. In other words, the legitimacy of the violent acts they sought to understand were already constituted in the minds of observers, witnesses, and the perpetrators of such acts, and this left neither guilt nor responsibility, as there were purportedly no discernible victims. Consonant with the recognition that violence is not a natural occurrence but a social, political, and moral choice, in the case of Arendt, though there is no denying of the fact that totalitarian regimes use power brutally and that they take advantage of the unique opportunities provided by war and turmoil for the control, subjugation, terrorization, and even annihilation of their citizens, Arendt insists on the crucial source of totalitarian power resting in the ways totalitarian structures complement the individual's sense of embodiment via presumed complete inclusion by the body politic. Similarly, for Patocka, analyzing violence by focusing on totalizing warfare in the post-secular context, removes the possibility of seeing it as mere irrationality, senselessness, atavism, or monstrosity, despite the immense scale of the damage incurred. Contemporary theatres of cruelty, whereby violence is committed in the name of anything from ethnicity to religion, from neo-imperial grandeur to economic greed, cannot be understood as a consequence of disengaged reason. In order to confront its specificity beyond traditional explanations of mass violence, integrated phenomenological account of violence must trace the correlation between excess and human capabilities to create, but also to respond to it. The monopolizing appropriation of human freedom to appease the appeal of claiming foundational sovereignty, and thus in essence breaking away from genuine relationality, is the first essential step towards the transfiguration of the everyday qua violence. In the lived world, where experience is intersubjective, violence cannot be construed as an external act. The phenomenological understanding of violence suggested in these podcasts is initiated by the Patocka-Arendt trajectory of rereading our responsibility in the face of totalizing violence, which is marked by excess. Thank you for joining us on this journey of exploring the contemporary relevance and applications of phenomenology of violence. You can find a list of citations as well as additional sources in the description section of these podcasts. Please feel free to use them in educational and public settings. These are very important issues, and I hope you enjoyed the series.